Profile. A fact-finding mission on matters of development by the Government Information Service.
The government of Dominica in 2009 introduced a program to complement its drive to assist the country's elderly, needy, and vulnerable. The program, a brainchild of the island's Prime Minister Honorable Roosevelt Skerritt, was dubbed Yes, We Care.
I felt that we needed to go to these people who have worked to build this country under very difficult circumstances, that somebody needed to say to them, yes, we care about them.
The desire of the Dominica leader to develop this program was born following his personal visits to some communities and coming face to face with elderly people in deplorable conditions.
I went to places and the older folks were living in dirt in some cases. So, in pure dirt. You know, they are not bathing months, you could see that. The sheets are all soiled, the homes are dark and gloomy. You know, it was really terrible.
On Monday, August 25, 2008, the government convened a one-day consultation aimed at formulating a comprehensive program on the needs of the elderly with the assistance of stakeholder organizations and interested parties. 1 year later, the Yes We Care program was officially launched.
May God bless our elderly. May God bless us all. I declare the Yes We Care program officially launched in Dominica.
Since then, with an initial contribution from the government of Libya of $1 million, it has saved the lives of many of the island's elderly persons.
So far, it has been a very good program.
When the program began last year, approximately 250 needy, housebound elderly individuals received food supplies and direct home care. 10 months later, the number of persons receiving care under that program was reduced to 230.
Some of them have been sent to the infirmary, and relatives also have taken some.
The program has also created employment for many across the country, including a coordinator, an administrative assistant, and 9 health district supervisors. Personal care and attention is being provided by 44 caregivers stationed in communities across the country. Those involved with the Yes We Care program and know its impact all agree that it has changed the way they look at the elderly.
When you have to go to the homes on a daily basis, you become so humble because we take things for granted in Dominica. Because we have, we believe everybody have. But there are persons with nothing at all, nothing at all.
Profile.
It's mid-morning. Supervisor of the Casbros Health District, Jennifer Grell, is on her way to see one of her caregivers at work in Toronto. We follow her along a dirt track and then try to keep up with her as she gains momentum. At the top, a small wooden house kept in place by wooden poles. Jennifer's approach is being monitored by Hillian Nation, who peeps out of his outside kitchen. The morning greeting has also caught the attention of 70-year-old Elena Nation, who is in a very quiet conversation with her caregiver Judith Wilshire. Jennifer's love and compassion for the elderly immediately comes to light. Nothing escapes her. Before the Yes We Care program, the 70-year-old Elena would be bathed by her 77-year-old husband, Hilaire.
He cannot do nothing, but he still has to take care of me. He have to make a little garden, but he cannot go.
Her prayers were answered when she was identified as one of the beneficiaries of the Yes We Care program.
And they come, they washing for me, they bathing me, they cleaning my house, and they leave me all right. So I glad for them.
Her quiet disposition and warm smile disappears for a moment as she's assisted across the room. A feat often taken for granted, but would be almost impossible without the help of her caregivers. Her husband, Hilaire, watches closely. It hurts him to see her this way, and how he wished he could help her, but he has his own limitations.
Well, my feeling is that feeling, because I myself sick. But I can stand up, so I have to help her. I have a back here. I want mostly 27 years since I have the back here.
So while he yearns to do everything he can for his wife, he has no choice but to leave this care in the hands of Judith.
Well, it's God alone that can say thank you. I thank you, God, for that. And God bless the minister who sent them there. Because they give me a big help.
Judith has always loved taking care of elderly persons, and despite its challenges, she finds solace in the fact that she has made a difference in the lives of Elena and the husband.
Well, I see a big change because she bathing every day. I was always clean. I had always clean. And she always clean, her clothes always clean on her.
Her interaction with Elena every day has created in her a new appreciation for the Yes We Care program.
People must take care of the elderly often because they need help.
Yes We Care program is very good because I didn't have nobody to take care of me, and I get them to taking care of me and bathing me every day, so I feel good.
Confident that her client Elena is taken care of, Judith leaves for the home of another client. As is the norm in many rural communities, there is no clearly defined pathway to houses. But one would not know this if they observed Judith and her supervisor walking almost in single file to the home of the next client, with the only available guide, an infant, on their heels.
Good morning. How are you?
Inside, 75-year-old Paulina Daniel is all smiles as her appearance is enhanced with a head wrap. It's not always smiles, however, for the 75-year-old. Over the years, it has become increasingly difficult to move around the home, to get a moment to sit on a wooden chair and watch outdoors.
I used to go outside and do my little weeding, do my little thing, cook my food, but all of a sudden, the food coming weak. I cannot open them to step.
For her, the turning point in her life came when the Yes We Care program began.
I find it's a good program, and I have two caretakers. Oh, wonderful, beautiful, wonderful, beautiful.
The beauty of this part of Dominica can be so captivating. One may get so enwrapped in scenes like this that the last thing on their mind is the challenges faced by the elderly in communities like these every day. It must be difficult for these caregivers who turn out daily to these homes ignoring the long distances which they have to travel. The road to the home of Mr. and Mrs. Meanwell Lockhart, for example, is not for the faint-hearted. But caregiver Virgin Challenger does it every day. Supervisor Jennifer Grell is taking that challenging walk today. Mr. Lockhart is feeling rather tired this morning, so he is still in bed. His caregiver, however, wants him to sit up for a moment, something which he is unable to achieve on his own. This is one of the reasons that she is there. His wife Clarice, 98, looks on.
He cannot hear well. He cannot talk. He come in more snow.
She feels his pain, but with her left leg amputated, there is nothing much she can do.
I cannot do nothing. And if you don't give me, I cannot eat. And my finger does cramp. All my finger cramp, you know. It's fight I'm fighting to see. I'm trying to open my finger. I can hardly open my hand. But God is good.
It has been difficult for Clarice and her husband these past few years, living alone with their cries for help meeting deaf ears.
People passing in my hand, I just ask them to throw my tinsel for me. They're only looking at me, they don't even telling me how they.
Virgin believes that the Yes We Care program was a necessity. She believes that the elderly should have someone to wipe away their tears and provide them with some tender loving care, the kind of care that can be found from the Yes We Care program.
You don't know tomorrow how you are going to come, and you would want somebody to assist you when you reach that stage.
Well, he come and he helping me a lot. When I don't have nothing, she does bring something for me. Both of them. I cannot say nothing about them. They're helping me a lot because I didn't have nobody helping me.
Supervisor of the district, Jennifer Grell, is a woman of few words, but her message is clear.
The Yes We Care program is a very excellent program, as it enhances the lives of our senior citizens and the less fortunate of the community.
For years, the less fortunate and elderly persons remained behind closed doors. It took the compassion of caregivers from the Yes We Care program to open these doors and administer care. 31-year-old Fenian Frederick lies in bed. He was in an accident over 9 years ago, something he remembers very little about.
On my way back, coming home, the accident happened. So I don't really know how it happened.
He is now unable to leave his bed to go to the washroom, so he wears pampers. He is entirely dependent on his caregiver, Moses Lockhart.
When he come, he go for water, he put me outside to be clean the house, wash him the dishes, carry water.
Moses, the only male caregiver in the Yes We Care program, has cared for Fenian for the past 7 months. And after days of cleaning his home and carrying water for his baths, he wonders what it would have been like for the 31-year-old had it not been for the Yes We Care program.
Well, I feel very good about it. I think it's a good program. I love doing my work. I take pleasure in doing it.
The Yes We Care program has had a major impact on the Marigot Health District, a district which is monitored closely by Supervisor Audrey Carlton James.
A lot of my elderly folks, be it in the Margaret Health District or the entire Dominica, they needed that help. And I must say it was a good initiative by the Prime Minister to bring in a program like that.
Sitting on a chair on a veranda in the mid-afternoon, 84-year-old Elena Williams, who is affectionately called Nanny, is in high spirits today. Her excitement stems from yet another visit from her caregiver, Eugene Daniel Roberts.
Sometimes I will cook, I comb my hair, because a person, a woman, has to comb every day. I'll bathe them every day, and then I will mop, I'll make up their bed. And I'll clean up her nails, cut up her nails, and clean her fingernails, her toenails.
Like many in the program, Nanny had worked hard in her youthful days in the development of her country.
And I used to work in Government Road. And I used to work at CDC. And I used to work at GIS.
During the past few years, however, she has been unable to take care of herself and her husband, Bryant, who has been ill for the past 22 years. From his kitchen, he watches his wife outside and is sad that he can't help. They are both comforted, though, that help is here for the Yes We Care program.
Praise the Lord. Give God thanks, because I always sit in long day and I say, if it was that, and my husband was stinking inside there because I cannot walk, and he himself cannot walk.
God bless Charity. Yes, I'm the Prime Minister. Well, I say God bless him.
Morris Johnson has been a neighbor and friend of the couple for years.
From the time the Yes We Care program, I feel happy in the way they're treating them, because these people, they really need that help. Remember, I tell you, I used to help them, but the help I was giving them could not compare with what they're getting from Yes We Care.
Profile.
It's just after 2 p.m. A northerly wind stirs the curtain of this small wooden house. It almost serves as a signal for the two caregivers and the supervisor of the Marigot district that it is okay to come in. Once inside, the caring nature of the team is brought to life. When he was first identified as a potential beneficiary of the Yes We Care program, Vivens Telemark of St. Joseph, who resides in Marigot, was in what the caregivers described as a miserable condition. It took days for all the members of the team to clear his home from the old and rust-filled irons, umbrellas, and two old mattresses.
They were in a kind of condition, we just had to burn everything.
I thank for the government, my government, that is doing for me. Because if it's not the lady, the lady out there, I will be diabetic. And there are people looking after me, cooking for me, doing all the things for me. Look, if I have bed for me, I was sleeping on the ground. Look, right now, I have a bed. I thank him.
The caregiver is proud of what she and the team were able to achieve with this client, and now understand why the Yes We Care program was necessary.
Oh, the Yes We Care program is a very good program. I can tell you, it's very good.
It's late afternoon, and 90-year-old Aldi Telemark from Kalibishi is looking out of his bedroom window as sunlight slowly disappears inside. He wants to change position now, but moving around has become increasingly difficult for the elderly man. just to get to the chair at the foot of his bed requires all the strength he can muster. With the encouragement of his caregiver Maria Rodney and his own determination, he succeeds. The smile on his face speaks volumes. His smile, however, should not be taken for granted. Life this past few years has not been easy.
Oh, well, it was very difficult. I couldn't do what I want to do. I was by myself alone, and morning and night, nobody to take care of me.
It has become more comfortable these days, thanks to the compassionate hands of his caregiver.
Since she taking care of me, I had a better feeling.
Her focus has been on the provision of care to Aldi, but Maria confesses that she too has been touched by the program.
We need to go out and take care of our elderly persons, because there are elderly persons out there that need help. There are elderly persons out there, sometimes when I go home, I say, boy, it's better when you don't know, because sometimes I cannot sleep. There are nights I cannot sleep, because sometimes when you go by certain persons and you see they doesn't have anything to eat.
It's mid-morning in La Plaine, a community located on the southeast of Dominica. A hairdresser is on the job. Her client, 85-year-old Aldif Joseph. This is just one of several skills caregiver Evelyn Samuel must take with her as she seeks to administer care to the elderly woman.
My pussy comb my hair and she bathed me. And she washed my clothes. Yes, do everything for me.
Evelyn has, during the past few months, provided a level of care which has made life much easier for Aldif.
Taking care of the elderly is like a blessing.
In the yard outside, a 60-year-old beneficiary of the program engages in discussion with the district supervisor, Elin Stevenson.
She come in your hair?
Yeah.
And what again?
What?
She brushing your teeth?
What? What?
Okay. What again? What's she doing for you?
What? Yeah.
She bathing you?
Bathing you.
Okay.
For the caregiver, the Yes We Care program has come at the right time for the island's elderly people.
Words cannot describe it. It's a wonderful program. And I want to thank the Prime Minister for thinking about it and initiating it.
Elin Stevenson supervises the Yes We Care program in the communities of Grandfort to Delices. The experience has been an eye-opener for her.
I never knew people in my district were living in those kind of conditions.
When she signed on to head the program in her district, this was not what she expected.
We met a lot of things, you know. Like poor sanitation. We met the people, some of them they would not have a bath for months. And I had two clients. When my caregiver went to take care of them, we had to throw the first clothes that we met them with, because it couldn't wash nothing.
In the dim light from the bedroom window, she has a smile which would light up a room. For years, however, the smile of 47-year-old Lucille Peters was clouded with discomfort.
The We Care program is very important to me, because if I wasn't on it, nobody would not know what I'm going through. Because my boys, I have two boys, they're always in jail, and one alone I have, and it's so depressing. He used to feel bad to see he have to bathe me.
The care she receives from the Yes We Care program has given her a fresh look at life.
It makes me feel good, it makes me feel happy, it makes me feel, you know, somebody cares.
caregiver from the Granby district, Royet Blaise, is ensuring that her 79-year-old client, Laura Toussaint, has his mid-morning bath. For her, this is priority.
When we first started the program, it was in a very, I would say, more or less miserable condition.
Looking at his condition back then had really touched her, and she now works with a passion to ensure that his home is cleaned and he received the care that he deserves. It is difficult moving around, but Laura tries to help himself at every given opportunity. For him, his life depends on the care he receives from Royet each day.
Well, for me, it's a good thing for me. See, my things are like, I'm going to take care of more. God, you think, if you are going to treat him, yeah.
Profile.
Supervisor of the Granby District, Melanda Paul, is proud to be part of the Yes We Care program. Her impressions of the program continues to be boosted every day she visits the home and listens to the experiences of clients. Clients like 89-year-old Paulina John Lewis and her husband.
Well, she paving, shaving, my husband, always having him clean. Once, when she is not present, myself and my son bathe him and dress him and do everything.
It is testimonies like these which makes Melanda a very proud supervisor, proud to be part of a life-changing program.
For some of the people, they had absolutely nobody to really care for them. It's like a neighbor would stop by once in a while. But it's like presently they have care every day. They get a meal, they get a bath every day.
Profile.
Rosmond Libre is a supervisor of the Yes We Care program in the Roseau Central, Bath Estate, Goodwill, Scottshead, and the Roseau Valley. Today, she is visiting 70-year-old Una Charles in Bath Estate.
I went to the hospital and make an operation. And when I come out in the hospital to make the operation, when they send me home, I didn't have nobody to see about me.
She is an amputee, and then although she had a walker, she was afraid to go to her bathroom. But after the caregiver, training, like how she should manage, she's able to go by to the bathroom by herself with no fear.
Anfia Bertrand is one of the caregivers who work in this district.
When you have to go into the homes of some of the people that are assigned to you, and you have to see their condition, you can say this program was a godsend program.
For Anfia, working with this program has been an eye-opener.
I know we talk about some sort of poverty in Dominica and the way that people live, but I experienced it for myself. I really never thought we had people living in this condition. I mean, the state of their homes and that kind of thing, so it was a good experience for me.
The impact of the Yes We Care program on the lives of Dominica's elderly persons is very real. And like 80-year-old Bernadette Hillier, who is wheelchair-bound, they are living testimonies of the success stories associated with this social program.
I used to wash my little clothes sometimes. When I say I couldn't wash it again, I just let it. I used to wash one by one. And then because I have arthritis in my fingers, so anyway, I tried my best. I love my government very much. They're doing a nice program and I like it.
Thanks to the initiative of the Dominica leader and the hard work of those involved in this program, it is clear that the initial contribution by the Libyan government towards this social program was well spent. Contrary to the idea that the program was designed for 1 year, it has been confirmed that the Yes We Care program is here to stay.
I do not see it ending at all. I have given my commitment, I'll find the money. The money has to be found.
They have toiled. They have made their contribution to the development of the country's economy. And as they grow old and gray, it is now up to the population to say to the elderly among us, yes, we care.